Azar is in Middle Eastern lore, a spirit that possesses mostly married women, providing an acceptable opportunity for oppressed women to manipulate men. The Azar are malign, man-hating type of jinn, genie, capricious and much feared. The Azar attack women and demand beautiful clothes, jewelry, perfume, better treatment, and luxurious food and surroundings before they can be persuaded to depart. Such appeasement can get expensive, and many husbands suspect they are being manipulated, but they acquiesce, fearing punishment by the Azar. The possession and exorcism of the Azar typically proceeds as follows. The victim, suffering from some minor complaint, blames possession by the Azar, and other female relatives keep her from seeing a medical doctor, preferring the services of a female shaman, called Shecha-Easy Azar. For a fee, the Shecha identifies a Azar as the source of the woman's troubles and interrogates the Azar, sometimes in a recognizable language and sometimes in Azar language, understood only by the Shecha. After repeated conversations, the Azar offers to leave once the possessed victim receives lavish gifts and attention from her husband. On the afternoon of the Azar's scheduled departure, a beating the Azar ceremony is performed. The victim's female friends and relatives join her for the ceremony, much like a tea or party, often accompanied by a flute performance. The Shecha and her assistants chant the final exorcism rites, with music, and then often sacrifice a lamb. The lamb's blood is rubbed on the victim's forehead and elsewhere. She then dances madly, sways and finally faints. The Azar leaves. Azar exorcisms have become part of contemporary urban Islamic culture. In many large cities, such as Cairo, regular public exorcisms have been held. Women from all walks of life participate, whirling and dancing until the spirit leaves them and they return home, exhausted but entertained. Relief from the possession may be only temporary, returning upon another infraction committed by a husband. Men are expected to believe in the possession, which, in addition to giving women the freedom to ask for gifts, permits them to scold and upbraid their husbands in a manner that would be forbidden under normal circumstances.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.